we never fail. Your word we come to pass. Your word must surely stand. Cause you are God, you're not a man.
In the name of Jesus.
This is part two of the move of the Spirit this Pentecost Sunday. The subtopic is Be Ye Filled with the Holy Spirit. This comes from Ephesians chapter 5 verse 18, which says, do not be drunk on wine, which leads to debauchery. Instead, be filled with the Holy Spirit. To be filled means to be controlled, directed, and completely dominated by the Holy Spirit. That's exactly what being filled means. And therefore, as we bring this message to the hearing of the children of God, we ask that the heavens shall come down in a very special way. We pray that there shall be an open heaven through where the children of God shall receive the blessings of God. Because we know that without the Holy Spirit, we are nothing, we are doomed, we lack an essential commodity in our lives when the Holy Spirit is absent. But when He is present, we have everything we need because He is the custodian of the things of God and He is the one that unveils to us the mind of Christ. Therefore, we are so grateful that the Holy Spirit is in this place today. And where the Holy Spirit is, there can never be an invasion of demons and witches.
Amen.
Because the Holy Spirit keeps them off as He brings the Trinity of God in a place.
Amen.
So that the entire environment is under the domain of the King Jesus.
Amen.
Therefore we pray today, let your power come down.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Being filled with the Holy Spirit means to be controlled, directed, and completely dominated by the Holy Spirit. I want to give a warning again. Today I am going to give you so many scriptures. And warning number two, unless otherwise stated, all the scriptures I'm going to give are taken from King James Version. Ephesians chapter 1 verse 13. We are speaking about the Holy Spirit because it is 50 days since Jesus resurrected from the dead.
Amen.
And when He went, He told His disciples, tarry ye in Jerusalem. It is a tragedy for any man, any woman to try to engage in the work of God without the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
It is a mighty tragedy because Jesus waited until He was filled with the Holy Spirit.
Uh-huh.
And then He started the full-time ministry. I waited for a long time until I received a total transformation from the Holy Spirit before I started this ministry at the age of 22 years.
Amen.
Let's read verse 13 of Ephesians chapter 1 and see what the Holy Ghost does. Verse 13, in whom you also trusted, after that ye heard the word of the truth, the gospel of your salvation, in whom also, after that ye believed, ye were sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise. Look at that, very powerful. The Bible says when you gave your life to Jesus Christ, you were sealed with a seal.
Wow.
You received a seal.
Uh-huh.
You received a seal. You were sealed. That is what the Bible says. We were sealed with the Holy Spirit. This week, I was recommending another man of God, another apostle, for a government office. And I wrote the letter very well. I put the letterhead, I put everything, and I put my signatory on the letter, and then I gave him to upload the letter to the government website. When it went to the government website, they referred the letter back to us and said to us, this letter lacks something. And we were asking, what is it that it is lacking? And they said, the letter lacks a seal. We need the official rubber stamp of this man that recommended you. So the letter came back for us to put the official seal of Powerhouse Hebrew Church.
Amen.
When we do it, we are going to take it back and then we are going to okay that everything is okay. Any Christian who is born again without the Holy Spirit lacks an essential commodity in life. The devil
recognize you if you don't have the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
The Holy Spirit recognizes in you the power of the Spirit because that's the seal. We are sealed with the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, He puts a seal on you.
Uh-huh.
What does that letter mean? When it is put a seal, it means this is the property of powerhouse Impact Church. When you receive the Holy Spirit, you are sealed. What that means is you become officially the property of God.
Amen.
Many Christians are not properties of God because they lack the essential commodity in life called the seal.
Wow.
Ask your neighbor, do you have the seal of the Holy Spirit? Let's keep reading in verses 14 and see what the Bible says. Which is the earnest of our inheritance until the redemption of the purchased possession and to the praise of His glory. Look at that. The Bible says when you receive the Holy Spirit, it becomes an earnest. In other words, it becomes a guarantee. When you go to the bank and you want some money, they will ask for a guarantor. They can never give you money if you don't have a guarantor. What is the work of a guarantor? If you don't pay the bank, they go to the guarantor. The guarantor is supposed to pay. Therefore, you are free because the guarantor produces what we call a collateral. A collateral is what the bank uses as a title deed, maybe as a log book. They use it to give you money. Even if you are not the one who is having the title, even if the title is not yours, you get the money on behalf of the guarantor. Now the Holy Spirit is your guarantor.
Yes.
He's your guarantee. He's the one that has guaranteed you. And you, God, cancel us by sending Jesus to come and take us home. We are under the watchmanship of a guarantor, Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit keeps watching. He is the one who has given the first down payment for our purchased possession. Praise God.
Wow.
Therefore, Holy Spirit becomes your guarantor.
Amen.
He's your guarantor. He's your earnest. That's what the Bible says. Earnest of our inheritance until the redemption of our purchased possession.
Wow.
Glory.
Amen.
You are purchased. You are a property that is bought. And the first payment has been released. The first payment is the Holy Spirit.
Wow.
That's what the Bible is speaking to us about. The first payment for your purchased possession has been released by you receiving the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
So you are not of your own. You belong to someone. God has purchased you through the Holy Ghost, who has become your guaranteeing earnest possession.
Amen.
He's not earnest. Keep reading Ephesians chapter 1, verses 15. Wherefore, I also, after I hand your faith in the Lord, Paul saying, and the love unto all saints, verse 16, cease not to give thanks for thee, making mention of you in prayers. It is the Holy Spirit that helps us to pray.
Amen.
Verse 17, that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom,
wow,
and revelation into the knowledge of Him, the spirit of wisdom. The spirit of revelation is the Holy Spirit.
Wow.
That's the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit is the spirit of revelation and the spirit of wisdom. That's what the Bible says. I keep praying that the Lord may fill you with the spirit of revelation and the spirit of wisdom. That is the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is a package. And in Holy Spirit is wisdom, knowledge, revelation. So Paul says, I have never stopped praying for you that the Father of glory may give you the spirit of revelation and the spirit of wisdom. That is the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Wow. Let's keep reading and see what he says in verse 18. The eyes of your understanding being enlightened that ye may know what is the hope of his calling and what the riches of the glory of him is in inheritance in the saints. You need to know the inheritance,
yes,
of the saints. You need to know what is the riches of the glory is inheritance in Christ. The Holy Spirit reveals to you what your inheritance in Christ is.
Amen.
There are people in the house of God that are prodigal. They don't have anything in the house of God. They cannot sing. They cannot preach. You are bankrupt of the inheritance of Christ because you lack the Holy Spirit. When the Holy Spirit comes upon you, He releases the inheritance of His glory upon your life.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Whatever we have is not from our parents. We don't have anything from my dad. I don't have anything. The only thing I have from my father is DNA. The rest is the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit has given me a wife. The Holy Spirit has given me everything you see. Everything you see in me. Everything you see. Everything you hear is the Holy Spirit.
Wow.
Cannot lose the Holy Spirit. David says, take not away your Holy Spirit from me. Take not your spirit. Because a Christian without the Holy Spirit is doomed. It's nothing. It is the Holy Spirit that puts a difference.
Amen.
Holy Spirit opens your mind, opens your understanding, that you may know what your inheritance in Christ is.
Amen.
What is your inheritance in Christ?
Amen.
Revelations, powerful revelations of Paul here. Verses 19. And what is his? What is the exceeding greatness of his power to us one who believe? According to the working of his mighty power. The Holy Spirit is a spirit of power.
Oh,
it's a spirit of power. This Holy Spirit is a spirit of power. In Isaiah chapter 11, he calls him the spirit of might.
Might.
What the mystery power is that you begin to do things you are not normally supposed to do.
Uh-huh.
There are things we do here that we are not naturally able to do, but we do it because of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Wow! It's a spirit of might. It's a spirit of power. We cannot afford to lose the Holy Spirit. How can we lose the Holy Spirit?
Oh my.
How can we lose the Holy Spirit? The Holy Spirit came upon us in form of a dove, and then the voice in heaven was saying, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased." So the Holy Ghost came. Chapter 3 of Matthew. Chapter 4. The Holy Spirit led Jesus into the desert. And in the entire chapter, we see Jesus helped by the Holy Spirit to overcome temptations from the devil. Before we come to the end of Matthew chapter 4, we see Jesus now entering officially into full-time ministry after the Holy Spirit came upon him. And when he was given a book, the scroll, to read about himself, he went into the chapter that speaks about himself, speaking about the Holy Spirit. He opened the scripture and he read before them, saying, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to release captives, to give bread to the sight of the blind, to preach the good news to the poor, and to declare the acceptable year of the Lord." Immediately he finished reading his mission statement.
My God.
He closed the book and gave the book to them, and everybody wanted to hear, what is Jesus trying to say? But how many people here know that Jesus does not try to say? He says.
Yes.
He never tries to say.
My God.
He says. And the Bible says every eye was focused and cast on Jesus. Jesus looked at them and said, "This scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing today."
Yes,
ministry started.
Amen.
The ministry of power.
Amen.
The ministry of wisdom.
Amen.
The ministry of revelation.
Yes.
The ministry of might.
My God.
Started.
Jesus.
Devils tried to bring it down. They never brought Jesus down. Witches tried. Systems tried. They never brought him down because he was endued with the Holy Spirit.
Yes. Wow.
You cannot bring down a man who is anointed.
Oh,
yeah. We are not ignorant that witches are trying every day to bring us down. But with the power of the Holy Spirit, we will finish them.
Amen.
We will finish them every time.
Yes.
We are not ignorant. We know that sorcerers are trying. We know that the occult world is fighting day and night. We know they even come here and sit down and listen to us. But they have never affected us in any way.
Yes.
Because they carry the spirit of mind.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit.
Spirit of power.
Wow! before the end of this service, you will be transformed.
Amen.
You will be changed.
Amen.
Let's read verses 20. Which he wrought in Christ when he raised him from Wow. So it is the Holy Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead. Whoa. The scripture tells us that Jesus was raised from the dead by the Holy Spirit. For in another version in Romans, the Bible says he is the one that quickens our mortal bodies.
Amen.
This mortal body is flesh and blood. It can only be quickened by the Holy Spirit. It can be brought to life. Jesus speaking in John chapter 6, verses 6 and 3. The ones that I speak to you, they are spirit. They are full of the anointing. And they are life. So now we know when Paul is saying, I want to know him and the power of his resurrection. He actually wants to know the Holy Spirit.
Wow.
That Holy Spirit, that power, that invisible force that took Jesus and raised him and took him to heaven.
My God.
Remember one day he was standing and speaking to them, and then he was taken up to heaven. And when he went, and there were two angels that came and said, what are you gazing? The same way you see him go, it's the same way he will come, he will return. Wow! Just go and obey the word that he told you, tarry ye in Jerusalem. Wait for that power. It is the power that took him up against the force of gravity.
Yes.
It is the power of the Holy Spirit.
Wow.
How many people want the power of the Holy Ghost today? Oh, receive the Holy Ghost. Receive the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Wow! We didn't know that Jesus was raised by the Holy Spirit. Now we know. Now we know. Look at the work of the Holy Spirit in verses 21. Far above. Look at verse 20. And set him on his own right hand in the heavenly places. Far above. Look at what the Holy Spirit praises you. The Holy Spirit praises you above principalities and power and might and dominion. And every name that is named, not only in this world, but also in the one that is to come. That is where the Holy Spirit praises you. He praises you far above principalities and powers and rulers and dominion. Not only in this world, but even in the world to come. That's the work of the Holy Spirit. That's the work of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
He takes the Apostle Frank and praises him above. You can't touch him there. There's a place that I have a position in God. You cannot shake. You can't just shake it. You can't just shake it.
Wow.
I told you I cannot be shaken by miniskirts. I can't. There are pastors that are shaken by miniskirts. When a girl has a miniskirt, he cannot preach. You put it on, I preach it on. Yeah.
Amen.
Cannot shake me with your own neck. Can't. Try that somewhere else. The Holy Spirit has praised me above the principalities and powers and dominion. Not only in this world, but even in the world to come. I have a position.
That's my
power. The Holy
Spirit.
Amen. We have a position in God. The Holy Spirit takes you and puts you in a position where the devil cannot bring you down. If it was not, the Holy Spirit would be done. 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years without a church. But with the Holy Spirit. With the Holy Spirit. Pastors are backsliding so much. Then they say it is the girls that try to manipulate, to seduce. Let me submit to you that no man of God can be seduced by a girl in church. It is the man of God that seduces them. Yeah. It's not possible. I have 15 years experience. You cannot bring me down by your indecent dressing. It is only the man who has power who can bring the girl down. Praise God.
Amen.
When you go in the hospital, who becomes the other? Is it you who becomes the doctor, or the doctor becomes you? Who becomes the other? Who rejects the other one? Are you the one who rejects the doctor?
No.
So it is the doctor who literally transforms you to be like him, to be healed like him. The doctor cannot be sick like you. How can the pastor be the one who is being transformed?
Amen.
by the member, by you. It's not possible.
Yes.
It's not possible. Yes. When you enrolled in a computer class, did you become worse than your teacher, or you became like your teacher? So who influenced the other one?
The teacher.
The teacher influenced the student. The student cannot influence the teacher. So it is comfortable for me to say that the pastor seduced the member. All the members want to go to heaven. But the sheep, the shepherd is a wolf. The difference between a shepherd and a wolf is what you eat. For a shepherd, he feeds the sheep, but a wolf feeds on the sheep.
Oh my.
That's the difference. The wolf eats the sheep.
Yeah.
And the shepherd feeds the sheep. That's the difference. What? So it is the pastor that makes the members to backslide. No doubt about that. No doubt about that. Because they lack the Holy Spirit. When you have the Holy Spirit, you don't want to grieve him. I'll show you before I finish. Let's read verses 23. Which is his body and the fullness of him that filleth all in all. The power of God fills all in all. How many people want the Holy Spirit today?
Amen.
How many want the Holy Spirit?
Oh, I want
it. One day the Holy Spirit showed me a vision that the witches were sitting as a battalion, a group of millions of witches trying to stop what I say. That's why I'm very careful. I know the devil tries to disturb the atmosphere when I want to preach. Therefore, I bind him in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It is by, not by power, but by the, by my spirit.
Amen.
Now, let's see how you can be filled with the Holy Spirit. How many people want to know how can they can be filled with the Holy Spirit? How can you be filled with the Holy Spirit? If that be a fancy word, if you are here. You want to be filled with the Holy Spirit today. But how? Number one, you can be filled by the Holy Spirit, number one, by earnest expectation. Right? Earnest expectation. Luke chapter 24, verses 49. And be you guys send the promise of the Father upon you, but tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until you are endued with power from on high. We get filled with the Holy Spirit when we tarry in his presence. Tarry in his presence. Another version says, wait.
Amen.
If you are not waiting on the Holy Spirit, you cannot receive the Holy Spirit.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Amen.
For the Holy Spirit cannot, God cannot give you something you are not expecting. Do you know God cannot give you anything you are not expecting? Because the Bible says the expectations of a righteous man cannot be cut off. If you are expecting to be filled with the Holy Spirit, you will receive the Holy Spirit before the end of his service.
Amen.
Yeah. The expectations of a righteous cannot be cut off. So if you are expecting to be filled, you shall be filled. He cannot fill you if you are not expecting. Oh, I pray that God may help you to release your expectations unto him for the filling of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Eager expectation. Earnest expectation. Amen. Waiting earnestly. Number two, laying on of hands. You can be filled by the Holy Spirit when we lay our hands on you. Say amen.
Amen.
Say amen. Amen. Acts chapter 8, verse 17. Acts chapter 9, verse 17. And then Acts 19:6. When Paul had laid his hands upon them, the Holy Ghost came upon them, and they spake with tongues and prophesied.
Amen.
Look at that.
Wow.
The hand of a man of God carries power and transfers power. That's why I always tell the Lord, sanctify my hands. Sanctify my hands. When I lay my hand upon you like this, it should be a different hand. Yeah. Many hands come upon you without any effect. The hand of a man of God should bring an effect in your life.
Amen.
When he lays his hand upon you, there should be a transfer of the kingdom.
Amen.
There is no way we can transfer our kingdom to you without laying of hands.
Uh-huh.
We lay our hands on you so that we can transfer kingdom.
Yes.
Yeah. And this kingdom of the Holy Spirit can come to you when we lay our hands on you. Hey! Praise God.
Amen.
When Paul had laid his hands upon them, they received the Holy Spirit and they spoke in tongues. You must speak in tongues.
Amen.
Yeah. Can you ask the Lord to fill you with new tongues today?
Amen.
New tongues. New tongues.
Hey,
you may get to be muse muda mrefu. See, we found it out another 10 years ago. You need new ones. Hata kani upelekwa kwa ngala zinabadilishwa shock. Na badilishwa vitu vile muse inawekwa mupya. Ndio yaze ukibia kwa gari inaenda polepole. Unajua kuna vitu mupya ndani. Kuna vitu muse ndani. Unapeleka makani anatoa zile mzee anaweka mpya. Unaenda polepole hivi kwa sababu uko na ndimi muse wewe. Unataka ndimi mpya. When you receive new tongues, utaenda speak kama nini?
Yes.
Yeah. Hii pole pole unajikokota hivi, tukikuita ukuje uimbe unatembea pole pole, unatembea pole pole, unafika hapa kesho, ni kuonyesha you lack something new. You need the empowerment, you need something new.
Yes. I renew.
Yeah. You need to renew. You need to renew. You need to renew your feeling. Yeah, don't be contented with the tongues that you received 15 years ago. They are not conversant with the demons now. You need new ones.
Yes.
Be filled with the Holy Spirit and speak in tongues. Mm. Yeah. It's a man demon unaongea baka shetani amezikram. Ukisiongea na yeye anaongea na kumok. Come with new ones. My way, he's not there. Call the tongues of the angels. Yeah, there is some new tongues. Now can you keep rising, ascending levels? Mbia mwazako hizo ni mzee sana kwa nazo. Si mbadilisha mbuo ni alastia na kwa wana uhaile. Si mbadilisha tans. Unaweza kibadilisha kapi yatu kila siku. Na upadilisha tans. Unaweza kufaa viatu leo uone hii viatu sasa hivi baadhi usisiata watu wataanza kuyoko kuona nimevaa viatu zina kila wakati unakuja na tofauti na uchange ndio na ubadilishi dance ubadilishi dance chitani alikuzoea unaongea kama kabla unaanza kana basi viatu na basi na tai rapa koti una yaga mirimo kila kitu yosiri you need new pants you need new pants you need to be filled with the Holy Spirit. You need a new infilling of the Holy Ghost. Yeah. Today I lay my hands upon you. Receive the Holy Spirit. Receive the Holy Spirit. With the evidence of speaking in tongues.
Amen.
Yeah.
How?
You cannot say I belong to SDA. SDA does not receive tongues. You cannot say I belong to Catholic. Catholic does not receive tongues. Catholics are receiving Holy Spirit now.
Yes.
Anglicans are receiving Holy Spirit now.
Yeah.
Presbyterians are now being filled with the Holy Spirit. So which category do you belong that does not receive the Holy Spirit? Who said? That category that does not receive the Holy Spirit does not belong to God.
You are right.
You are yet to become the property of God.
Yeah.
When you become the property of God, you receive the infilling with the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Number three, breathing. Breathing on. Breathing on. You can receive the Holy Spirit by me breathing on you.
Amen.
Can read the Bible in John chapter 20, verses 22. And when he had said this, he breathed on them.
Wow.
And said to them, receive ye the Holy Spirit. This is Jesus.
Wow.
Yeah. Yes.
your breath should be anointed.
Men of God, our breath should be anointed.
Right.
When you breathe on someone, you get the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The breath of Christ was so anointed. If he breathes on you, you receive the Holy Ghost. As men of God, our breath should be sanctified.
Amen.
Our breath should be cleansed. So that when I breathe on you, you receive the Holy Ghost. Receive the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. When I breathe here, you receive the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
You receive the Holy Ghost. That's the only thing I can breathe out. Yeah. I can only breathe out to you the Holy Ghost. This is Jesus.
he breathed on them, saying, receive ye the Holy Ghost. The Holy Spirit came upon them. Yeah. When we breathe on you, you should receive the Holy Ghost. That's why a man of God should not be a man of jokes. A man of God should be a serious man. Uh-huh. Should be a serious man, because everything about the man of God is anointed.
Amen.
One day God said you don't have to carry the anointing oil. Anytime you saw it, it is anointed. Everything about me is anointed. Amen. My clothes are anointed. People have taken my jacket, put it on and get it.
Amen.
Everything about me is anointed.
Amen.
If I touch the food, it becomes clean. No more poison. I have the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
When I touch some drinks that have poison, they become sanctified.
Amen.
Wow.
Wow.
That's the man of God. You should be. Everything about me is anointed.
Amen.
Yeah. My clothes are anointed. Paul gave handkerchiefs and aprons. These aprons, they were anointed to carry healing. So, how much of you is anointed, please? How much of you is anointed?
Anointed.
Is your hair anointed? The devil keeps telling us that isn't where we are going to zinatengenezwa wa kusimu, zinatengenezwa hair. Kwa hivyo sasa tutatoa wapi sisi zimetengenezwa mbinguni? So tutatoa wapi? Chakula iko na sumu. Nguo ni za kusimu. Macho ile tunavaa earrings ni za kuzimu. Kwa hivyo tutatoa wapi sisi zimetengenezwa na Michael? Injo Michael.
Aha.
Ni wewe unafaa kuwa anointed. Ukiuza inapata anointing.
Amen.
This is so simple. Tesi ya mbiwa mboga zinaleta sijui kansa. Atuwezi tunakuwa mbiwa sijui kuku zinaleta kansa. Kwa hivyo ungetaka tukule nini basi? Ni nini hakina kansa? Tell me. Ni wewe una mafuta. Wewe ndio una anointing. Wewe ndio una Holy Spirit.
My God.
Okay, on the Holy Spirit, you apply your makeup, you apply your lipstick.
Yeah.
Is it called lipstick?
Yeah,
you apply what? And this one? This one is called what?
Yeah, I can't
feel. Namaskara Nikki.
Namaskara
Nikki. Come on. Everything you touch becomes anointed. Otherwise, the devil has, there are the world riot in iniquity. There is wickedness in the world.
Yeah.
Nothing is clean anymore. But what we touch becomes clean.
Amen.
We are going to use their iPhones. We are going to use their iPads. We are going to use their aeroplanes. We are going to use their visas. We are going to use their passports. We are going to use their cars. We are going to use everything they have. It belongs to our Jesus. We just need the Holy Ghost. Just need the Holy Ghost. We don't have things of our own.
Yes.
Angels in heaven do not produce hair. They produce grace.
Yes.
They produce power. Yes. They produce fire.
Oh, yes.
Whatever I touch becomes clean.
Amen. Amen.
I sanctify your hearts.
Amen.
I sanctify your hearts.
Amen.
I sanctify your hearts.
Amen.
So that whatever you shall touch
Amen.
Shall become clean.
Amen.
You shall touch poison. It is by no means clean. Yeah.
You shall touch snakes.
And they shall not hurt you.
Oh,
yeah.
Powerful.
Allah. Ado takula kuku. Zikona. Sinaitwa nini? Ikona sijui poison. Sijui nyama ya ng'ombe, sijui imedungwa. Sijui nini wafanye, sijui nini. Sasa tutakula nini na fish, hata pia fish ni mbaya. What do we do? Ni wewe utapokea Holy Spirit.
Imagine.
The cure is the Holy Spirit. It's the Holy Ghost. Hata hiyo gari unasema unatembea nayo matatu. Ni a devotional. How many Christian pastors have man matatus on the road? Very few, if any. We use their matatus. When we enter inside, the devil cannot operate. There can never be operation of demons in matatu. I am using. It is not possible. It is not possible. I am a principality.
Amen.
Yeah. I'm a principality as I walk.
Amen.
Oh my goodness. Oh my God.
Yes.
How many Christian men of God anointed have buildings? Very few. The house you live in belongs to a Freemason.
Yes. Magic.
Yeah. It's possible. But when I enter, their operation ceases.
Amen.
When I enter there, their operation ceases.
Yes,
yeah. They make our laptops, they make our keyboards, they make our microphones, they make
cross, but we need to touch them. They become anointed. You see the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
But as far as you are there, there can never be demonic operations in that home, that office. Ukifika hata kama unjaomba loudly, unaomba na moyo. Operations zake zote zinakufa. Yeah. Wow! How many require and need the Holy Ghost? Take the Holy Ghost! Kama mkuu wako anasema usivae henda na baraka, ni ya heri. Na wewe ukiona Mungu gani? Kwani wewe una Mungu gani ati hakuna ati usijump to try to the quality of chat with black and red. It is a color of hell. Who say it? Where is it in the Bible?
We sanctify them.
Holy Spirit can sanctify any color. It is the Lord that brought the rainbow. And then the LGBTQ took the rainbow. It does not belong to them. The rainbow is for us to enjoy the creation of God, the beauty of the creation of God, the colors that are amazing, that are wow. Every time Adam rose, he said, wow. Everything was beautiful, the Bible says. Everything the Lord created was good. What is it this one, our Jawi? What are the angels of God doing? I carry the message of the kingdom of God. So what are the angels doing? Why are they comfortable in heaven? They should not be sitting there. They should not be staying. They should be here ministering to me. They are ministering in spirits.
Yes.
Say, Mazita Tisho na Shetani.
Mazita Tisho na Shetani.
Si sebi wachawi wako. Wako. Lakini the power we carry is more.
Yeah.
It is more than rich.
We discovered it.
I don't know yesterday. I don't know why Christians are so witchcraft conscious. Witchcraft conscious. They always mention witchcraft and Satan more than Jesus. Nona kama kuna uchawi hapa. Nakemea uchawi. Nakemea mganga. Na awiti Yesu. Nakemea mganga. Any witchcraft operation. Naye malaika anafanya kazi gani?
Tumeacha kazi.
How many times do you mention Jesus a day? And how many times do you mention Satan a day? Hiyo unaona iko na nguvu nyingi ndio unaabudu. Yeah. Now una mention Satan 20 times. Na Yesu mara mbili. You are worshiping Satan.
True.
With your mouth. We cannot afford to worship the devil with our mouth. We should not give Satan airtime. Yeah. Unapea Satan airtime na mdomo. Hallelujah, naona kama nimeroga. Mimi sijui mchawi gani aliniroga, sijui ni mganga gani. Watu wanakuja kanisani kuambiwa ulirogwa na nani? Niliona kama ni atakuwa na kuroga. Wanawekewa tu vitu kwa nguvu huku, alafu anatoa. All this is nonsense, it shall die, it shall cease. The word of God shall produce the results.
Yes.
For the Lord says, I am watching over my word to perform it. Anangoja nimalizie hii nihubiri, I perform. Maana alinituma. We cannot be witchcraft conscious more than Jesus conscious. We need the Holy Spirit. We need the Holy Spirit. Hakuna mtu hakuna roho mtakatifu mdogo. Nobody carries the Holy Spirit and remains small. Nobody.
Amen.
Anybody carrying the Holy Spirit is great. All of Roberts, David Prince, Kenneth Hagin,
Benson
in the hustle, wow. Smith Wigglesworth, Ryan Ponke,
Theo Osborne,
men that carry fire, they are great.
Billy Graham.
Maurice Eru. Men that carry fire and the Holy Spirit are never small. You see the Holy Ghost. Receive the Holy Spirit. Receive the Holy Spirit. Receive the Holy Ghost.
Holy Spirit.
1 year from now, you will be great people.
Amen. I receive.
People are selecting their pastors are choosing people with money and not people with the Holy Spirit.
Oh God.
That's why the church is going down. We love and we respect people who God has blessed. We love all for them. But that does not qualify them for leadership positions. Money does not qualify anybody.
Amen.
But Barnabas was not an apostle. He handled the money, he brought the money in the church.
But he was not an apostle. He became an apostle as he moved on.
Yes.
He brought the money to the apostles' feet, to Peter, and Peter never mentioned it. It is the Bible that tells us Peter did not make it a sermon. Mm-hmm. But now, as a man of God, oh, give us a million shillings that we may build. He never made it a sermon. Peter never preached about Barnabas. Although Barnabas brought the money that he had sold the land to him. We respect people with money and we are paid for you to get money. But money is not the quality that we look unto.
Amen.
For your leadership position.
Amen.
Number four, anointing oil. You can receive the Holy Spirit when we anoint you. 1 Samuel 16:13. Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of brethren. That's David. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day forward. So Samuel rose up and went to Ramah. When we anoint you, you can be filled, and you will be filled.
Amen.
With the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Anointing oil, when the anointing oil touches you, receive the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
When the anointing oil touched David, the Holy Spirit came upon him. Praise God.
Amen.
Number five, anointed message. Acts chapter 10, verses 44. While Peter yet spake these things, the Holy Ghost fell on them which heard the word. When I preach the word of God powerfully to you, you receive the Holy Spirit. It is a disaster to stay in a church where the word is not preached under power. It's a disaster. A mighty disaster. Yeah.
It's dangerous.
It is dangerous. Because the Bible says when the demons leave a man, they go to dry places. They go to dry places. Where is the dry place? Praise God. Do you think the dry place is the wilderness?
No.
Do you think it is in a desert in Saudi Arabia?
No.
Dry places are dry churches.
The church without
the Holy Spirit is a dry place.
Yes.
That's where demons, all the demons that we cast out from a fiery environment, they run to a dry environment, whether it is a church, whether it is a home, whether it is a cow, whether it is any dry prison, that's the abode of demons.
Any dry person.
Any dry man is a carrier of demons. When the Holy Spirit enters you, he removes the demons.
Yes.
Because you cannot be dry when you are in his presence.
Amen.
That's why you fall. That's why you stagger like a drunken man. When the Holy Spirit comes upon you. Wow.
Wow.
Wow. So anointed message. Anointed word. When a powerful message is released on you, the Holy Spirit works. As Peter was speaking, the Holy Spirit entered into them. No ring of hands, no anointing, the message.
Wow.
Most of the miracles I saw are the miracles that happened when I was preaching, not when I was praying. It is when I was preaching that a crippled man in India rose up. It is when I was preaching in Dagoretti, when a man who had a broken limb, never walked for 6 years, stood up. It is when I was preaching and releasing the anointing, when that wound in that church, it was 6 years, cancerous wound, God healed when I was preaching. A message that carries the fire and the power of God is a message that can transform you forever.
Yes.
Number six, ask. Number six, ask. Holy Spirit never comes upon any man who cannot ask. You have to ask for the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is a gift given to only those that ask. If you don't ask, forget being a Pentecostal evangelical. Forget. Don't say that the Holy Spirit will come upon the evangelicals. The Holy Ghost shall fall upon all the Pentecostals. Forget that. Ask for the Holy Spirit. You shall receive in the book of Luke chapter 11 verse 13. The Bible says, if ye then, being evil, know how to give good gifts. Look at that. Good gifts unto your children. How much more shall your heavenly Father give you the Holy Spirit to them that ask him? You see? Hey! Praise God.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
If you are a father or a mother, when your child asks for a bread, do you give them a stone? When they ask for a fish, do you give them a scorpion?
No.
If then
you evil fathers. You are evil. Jesus said, the earthly fathers are evil, but the heavenly father is righteous. If he is a holy God, if the wicked can give their children what they ask, how much more than your heavenly father give you the gift of the Holy Spirit to them that ask?
Amen.
How many are asking for the Holy Ghost?
I ask for the Holy Ghost.
Say, I ask for the Holy Ghost.
I ask for the Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost, come upon me.
Holy Ghost, come upon me.
Holy Ghost, come upon me. Amen. What is the design of the Holy Spirit coming and filling us? What design does God use to fill us? That's the question we are answering. Number one, he can use the design of pouring. Wow. Pouring. That's the one design. Design number one, pouring on. Wow. So wow. God can pour his spirit on the children of God.
Amen.
Joel chapter 2 verse 28. It shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Joel 2:28. And your sons and daughters shall prophesy. Look at the results of the Holy Spirit. Prophecy. Old men shall dream dreams. These are not dreams out of food. These are dreams of the Holy Spirit. Your young men shall see visions. Now God says, there is a time that is coming. I will pour my Holy Spirit.
Uh-huh.
Pour the Holy Spirit.
Pour
the Holy Spirit. Yeah, I will pour the Holy Spirit upon my children. That's one design. It is one design of God feeding his children by pouring. Lift up your hands and say, Lord, pour upon me the Holy Ghost.
Lord, pour upon me the Holy Ghost.
It is his design. He can design to pour the Holy Ghost on you like water, like rain. Many instances I'm preaching, the Holy Ghost has been poured upon the children of God.
Amen.
In many instances. Hey, praise God.
Amen.
One design, pouring. Say pouring.
Pouring.
Yeah, he can pour the Holy Ghost.
So that you become flooded with the Holy Spirit.
Become flooded with the Holy Spirit. Number two, coming upon. He can decide to pour. He can decide to send the Holy Spirit to come upon him. First Samuel 10:10. And when they came thither to the hill, behold, a company of prophets met him, and the Spirit of God came upon him, and he prophesied upon them.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit can come upon him. Design number two, coming upon. Yeah, the Holy Spirit can decide to come upon him.
Amen.
Yeah. Wow, so that you carry the Holy Spirit. Like Jesus, the Holy Spirit came upon him in form of a dove. So God design number two is to send his Holy Spirit upon, to come upon. Hey, how many want the Holy Spirit to come upon them today? May the Holy Spirit come upon you in the name of Jesus.
Yeah. Number three,
by falling on, falling. The Holy Spirit can fall on you. Especially people who have a certain curse or a certain demon or a certain a stronghold. The Holy Spirit falls on them. Kafra. Suddenly the Holy Spirit falls on him. I have seen it. We were just speaking, then we said the Holy Spirit, bah! The man falls down, screams, and many things happen, and the Holy Spirit falls on him. Yeah, the Lord can decide to send the Holy Spirit to you, that he falls on you because of a challenge you are going through. Because if you have any challenge, you only need to yield to God. Yield to the Holy Spirit. Yield. Yield. To yield is to kujiachilia. Ukijiachilia, Holy Spirit akuangukie tu. Shida zingine zinaisha.
Shida
zingine zimeenda. Lakini kwa sababu ya kukaa kama mwanasiasa na kukauka.
We cannot be resolved when we are praying for you. We will pray for the politicians. Let them receive the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit can fall on you. Acts chapter 10 verse 44. While Peter yet spake these words, the Holy Ghost fell on all of them which heard the word. While Peter was preaching the word of God, the power of God, the Holy Ghost fell on them. The Holy Ghost can descend to fall on you. Praise God. Amen. Amen. In Acts chapter 11, verse 15, Acts 11, 15, Peter is reporting what happened in Acts chapter 10, verse 44, and he says, "And as I began to speak, the Holy Ghost fell on them as on us at the beginning." Peter is reporting what happened when he released the Holy Spirit upon the Gentiles. Then why are people not filled with the Holy Spirit? Why? Why are the people not filled with the Holy Ghost? It's because they do the don'ts. So now we want to see what are the don'ts. Every time you do this don't. When you do this don't, the Holy Spirit will never come upon you. Number one, don't blaspheme. They blaspheme. When they do the don'ts, Holy Spirit will never come upon them. Number one, when they do the blaspheming. The Bible says, do not blaspheme. Don't blaspheme. In Matthew chapter 12, verse 1. Wherefore I say unto you, all manner of sin and blasphemy shall be forgiven unto men. But the blasphemy against the Holy Ghost shall not be forgiven men. So men that blaspheme the Holy Ghost can never be able to receive the Holy Spirit. So what is blasphemy to the Holy Spirit? Blasphemy to the Holy Spirit includes cursing. It includes cursing and attributing Holy Spirit activities to Satan and the flesh. That is a very important statement I want to repeat. It includes cursing and attributing Holy Spirit activity to Satan and the flesh. That is what is called blasphemy to the Holy Spirit. Cursing the Holy Spirit and attributing the activities of the Holy Spirit to Satan.
My God.
And to flesh. What does that mean? When there is a move of God in a place and people begin to curse and to say that was not God, that was the devil, that was Satan, I don't believe that man. That mouth can never receive the Holy Spirit. That man can never receive the Holy Spirit. When you attribute the activities of the Holy Spirit to Satan. Ukiona mtu ameanguka chini, akainua miguu, ukaanza kusema kanisa haina adabu. Basa naombeaka watu, wanaanza kuonyesha aibu. Wanaanza kusema nini? You can never receive the Holy Spirit when you curse the Holy Spirit. When you see it, ilikuwa nyama ni kujifanya ni fresh. It is not apostle Frank kujifanya. Anajifanyanga amepakwa. You can never receive the Holy Spirit because you are attributing the works of the Holy Spirit in me to Satan. Blasphemy, that cannot be forgiven. When you do the don'ts, you can never receive the Holy Spirit. Don't blaspheme.
Kwa hivyo mchunge sana kusema mtu fulani fulani mtu wa Mungu, aba kama hauna uhakika sana usiseme mtu wa Mungu yule ninaona kama si wa Mungu, sijui pende hii na nikuja sijui alikazi sijui hiyo inaweza fanya utawai jazwa milele. Eh, Mungu atusamee sana.
You can never receive the Holy Spirit because you are calling good what is bad and bad what is good. Can never receive the Holy Spirit. Number two, don't resist. There are people who resist the Holy Spirit.
Acts 7:51. You stiff-necked.
This must be Stephen preaching.
You stiff-necked and uncircumcised in heart and ears. You do always resist the Holy Ghost as your fathers also did.
My God.
You are always resisting the Holy Ghost. You are always resisting the Holy Ghost. You are always resisting the Holy Ghost.
What does that mean?
Rejecting the message of the Holy Ghost is resisting the author of the message. When you resist the message of the Holy Ghost, you are resisting the author of the message. Who is the Holy Ghost? When the Holy Spirit sends a message to you and you say, the message belongs to my friend, I wish so and so was here to hear it. You are stiff-necked and uncircumcised in heart.
You are resisting the Holy Ghost. You will never receive the Holy Ghost forever. If you resist the Holy Spirit, kupinga roho mtakatifu. Anataka
kutembelea uanguke lakini umekauka uwezi. Roho anakuambia piga magoti nikutembelee, unasimama bado na kuinoma na kukauka. Always resisting the Holy Ghost. Stephen preached the message. Preached the word. Powerful message. But they resisted and they took so they stoned him. He said, O ye of stiff-necked men and uncircumcised of heart, you always resist the Holy Spirit like your fathers did. Always resisting the Holy Ghost. The Holy Spirit tells you, give 1,000. You resist. So try because you resist the Holy Spirit. One day the Holy Spirit came upon me and electrocuted my right hand. It was like fire burning my right hand. My hand became hot like fire. The following Sunday, I touched the anointing oil and gave it to one of my sons. He touched it. It burned his hand. To be filled with the Holy Spirit means to be controlled.
Directed.
To be directed and to be completely dominated by the Holy Spirit. Are you instructed? Are you dominated? Are you
controlled
by the Holy Spirit? You are the one who controls him and you want him to feed you. Controller of the Holy Spirit. Resisting the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit has full control in this church.
Amen.
Let there be a flow of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Don't resist him. Don't resist him. For one day you'll need him. Lift up your hands and say, I'm sorry, Holy Spirit.
I am sorry
for resisting you. Number three, do not grieve. Are you seeing the don'ts?
Yes.
Yeah.
Ready, overflow. Ready, overflow. Ready, overflow. Let them. Wow.
Let the fire, let the power
flow.
Don't cut it, let it flow. Don't grieve. Ephesians chapter 4, verses 30. The Bible says, and grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, whereby you were sealed unto the day of redemption. Don't grieve him. What does it mean to grieve the Holy Spirit? It is when we put the Holy Spirit in a state of sorrow and sadness. Oh my God. We are never to bring sorrow and sadness to the Holy Spirit by restricting his move and activities in the body of Christ. Yeah. When you restrict the move of the Holy Spirit upon the children of God, you are grieving him. Unamukusunisha roho. You can never be filled with the Holy Spirit that you grieve.
Yes.
Holy Spirit is not a force. He is a man. He is a person. So he has feelings. When he wants to do something and you stop him, he feels bad. He feels sorrow. He feels sad. Why are you causing sorrow and sadness to the Holy Spirit? A young man came before the woman of God, Catherine Kuman. A young man was coming because Catherine Kuman carried the fire of honor and the power of God. As she moved around anywhere, men were saved with the Holy Spirit. As she walked and moved, people are falling under the Spirit. Whether you are in the kitchen or in the hospital or in the hotel, you all fall down. And there was a young man who came in the meeting. And Catherine was there, asking how many need the Holy Spirit. The young man came in front. Catherine looked at him, saying, pointing to him, saying, you don't know what you are asking for. I wish you know what you are asking for. The Holy Spirit can change your life. By the time she finished, the boy was down. Filled with the Holy Spirit, that boy became the today's Benihim. Is a Benihim today. A man who was not known. A man who was he was first healed of stammering by the finger that was pointed on him, and he received the Holy Ghost and he became an international icon. You have resisted and grieved and blasphemed. That is why you are Rocco. You are Rocco because you have blasphemed the Holy Ghost. You have resisted the Holy Ghost. Lift up your hands and say, I repent.
I
of blasphemy.
I repent
of resisting the Holy Spirit.
I repent
of grieving the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, come upon me now. Oh, receive the Holy Spirit in Jesus' name. Let me give you three bullets and finish. One, Zechariah 4:6. These are bullets that can bring down the devil. Bullets number one, Zechariah 4:6. The Bible says, then he answered and spake unto me, saying, this is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel. Say, not by might, not by power, but by the Spirit, says the Lord of hosts. It is not by power we are going to make it. It is not by might you are going to make it. By his Spirit, by his Spirit, but by my Spirit you shall make it. So it is not by might we are preaching. It is not by might we came here. It is not by power we are able to be doing what we are doing. It is by his Spirit. Bullet number one. It is by the Spirit you are going to make it.
Amen.
That's the first bullet. You not make it because you are running. You not make it because you are from a very good family. You not make it because you are beautiful, because you are not. You not make it because you are handsome, because you are not. You will make it. If you look at the men that God uses, they are not beautiful. But when the Spirit comes upon them, they become admirable, my friend. You all admire Smith Rivers, but look at him naturally. You admire Benson in the house, but look at him now. There is not a man you can admire. The same way with Jesus. He's a man. The Bible says you cannot behold his beauty. He had no beauty to behold. But when the Holy Ghost came upon him, he became our darling.
Yes.
Yeah.
Darling.
We became a darling to many people because of the Holy Spirit. It's not by power, it's not by might, but by his Spirit. Bullet number two, Isaiah 59, verse 19. So shall they fear the name of the Lord from the west, and his glory from the rising of the sun. When the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord shall lift a standard against him. That's another powerful bullet. That the Holy Ghost is the one that raises the standard against the enemy. When the enemy comes in like a flood, he wants to flood you. The Holy Spirit lifts a standard that the flood comes and passes under you. You are not overwhelmed. How many people here want the Holy Spirit today?
Amen.
See the Holy Spirit, for it is the Holy Spirit that reads the standard. Wow. We started by saying the Holy Spirit has put us in a position far above principalities and powers and dominion. So when the enemy shall come in like a flood, the Holy Ghost takes you and raises a standard for you, and the flood passes and you.
You
remain stable.
Right.
Bullet number two. Bullet number three. It is Ezekiel 37, verse 14. I will put my Spirit in you, and you will live, and I will settle you in your own land. Then you will know that I, the Lord, have spoken, and I have done it, declares the Lord. The Lord will put his Spirit on you, and you shall live, not death.
No
premature death. You shall live. Number two, he will give you settlement. How many people here want to settle? You want to settle in your own home? You want to settle in your own land? You want to settle with your own car? Oh, hallelujah. The Bible says, I will release the Holy Spirit upon you, and I will settle you. I will settle. Look at that. I will settle you in your own land.
Powerful.
It is the Holy Spirit that settles the children of God in the land that God intends them to be. It is the Holy Spirit that settled the children of Israel in Canaan. It was the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
That's why they had to undergo two baptisms. One baptism in Red Sea. Hallelujah. That is the baptism of water. And then they had to undergo the second baptism. The baptism at Jordan. The picture of baptism in the Spirit. When you are baptized in the Spirit of God, you enter into your inheritance.
Amen.
You receive your inheritance from God when you receive the Holy Ghost.
Amen. Wow.
And then he settles you in your own land. Mm. Do you know that Canaan did not belong to Israelites? Canaan belonged to Canaanites.
Yes.
But because of the baptism of the Holy Spirit at Jordan, God took the land of Canaanites and gave it to the children of Israel, who are his children, who are baptized and filled with the Holy Ghost. When you are filled with the Holy Ghost, you will never lack an inheritance.
Amen.
You never lack an inheritance.
Lift up your hands and tell the Lord, fill me with the Holy Ghost. Fill me with the Holy Ghost. Fill me with the Holy Ghost.
Your word will never fail. Your word will come to pass. Your word must surely stand. Cause you are God, you're not a man.